invite Dr. Rajiv Shah to give his talk on ankle malunion approach and management. Over to Dr. Rajiv Shah.
Good morning again. When we speak about malunited ankle fracture, the question is, what are the available modalities for treating this malunion? And the first and foremost and most important is revising the fixation, correcting the fixation. The second is realignment with osteotomy, which could be either proximal or it could even be distal. The third could be ankle replacement, and fourth could be fusion or ankle arthrodesis. So I'll take you one by one onto each of this, that when do you really use it. So revision fixation, ideally speaking, duration may not matter. People have revised ankle fixations even after at the end of 12 months. While there is no optimal time to perform reconstruction, the fact of the life is patients continue to improve up to 7 years post reconstruction. So message is very clear. And what are the principles of revision surgery? We'll have to lengthen the fibula. You will have to correct the talar tilt. You will have to fix the medial malleolus. If required, you might have to fix syndesmosis. And sometimes you might have to do ligament reconstruction, certain releases, plus or minus arthroscopy. A patient who presented delayed at the end of 8 weeks to me with this kind of a treatment being done by the bone setter. Can I have a pointer, please? Treated by bone setter, and then he was taken to the surgery. Fibula was taken first, and then that was the radiological analysis. This is what is the line of ankle joint, and this is the dime sign. I was talking yesterday to few of the people, and this is the surest sign that you have established the length of the fibula properly. And then a leg screw fixation of fibula, posterior malleolus followed the fibula, everything fall back into place automatically, and neutralization plate was given. That was the final fixation. Posterior 20th screw for the posterior malleolus and medial malleolus was fixed. Another case, inadequate surgery, malreduced ankle, syndesmotic widening, fibula rotated like this, fibula taken up first, and then reduction of the syndesmosis, a fibula plate, osteotomy, syndesmotic screw, and things went okay. Some impacted malunion of medial malleolus may not be revised, because you know that would give rise to a focal level of defect which you may be able to get out with. Do revise or fix posterior malleolar fragment. May it be more than 25%, or if there is an articular step of more than 2 mm or displacement of more than 3 mm. That kind of a situation, you need to go in, revise and fix it. Do revise all fibular fixation with shortening, malrotation and syndesmotic injuries. All this needs revision, because if you can see, arthritis has not yet set in, and you could go in and revise this. Look at this kind of a situation, this kind of a situation, it needs fixation. That's a case of Dr. Dillon, 4.5 months post-op reconstruction. That was a post-op presentation, 4.5 months with this sort of fixation. He went on medially, removed the implants, did the osteotomy, and that was the medial side. Then went on to the lateral side, cleaned up the syndesmosis, did the transverse osteotomy of the fibula, lengthened the fibula, punched out a graft in between that created length, and then this is how it was ultimately stabilized, and patient did well. So message is very clear. If there is no set arthritis, try to revise ankle malunion. And before that, doing that, you could get a CT scan, which would be an ideal parameter to tell you where do you want to go and how do you want to go. The second option could be realignment with osteotomy. And this could be a proximal osteotomy or it could be a distal osteotomy. Early cases of focal ankle arthritis, you could get out with supramalleolar osteotomy, like in this case. Look at the way heel is lying into varus. Ankle will not tolerate it. That's a standing view. And then it was revised with supramalleolar osteotomy, and that's the healing. For an varus ankle, you could go in for medial open wedge supramalleolar or a lateral closed wedge supramalleolar, depending upon the skin condition. A lateral displacement hindfoot osteotomy can also be done. For a valgus ankle, you could go for medializing calcaneal sliding osteotomy if the valgus is mild. But if the valgus is more, you should go in for an osteotomy proximal to the ankle. That's medial closed wedge supramalleolar or lateral closed wedge supramalleolar. And you might be obliged to do ligament reconstruction together with this. Total ankle replacement. Implant is not yet available in our country. Whatever cases we have done are at Indo-US foot and ankle courses as demonstration cases, and one case at IFASCON. The question is when to replace the joint, when there is minimal deformity. There is no infection, no neuropathy, no vascular compromise, no AVN, and a very good soft tissue envelope. So practically speaking, ankle replacement has got a very limited indication. Now this was a patient from, this was a doctor from Maharashtra who was treated like this, and then this is how his fibular malunion was corrected. That is how it looked like before replacement, and then a star total ankle replacement was done. Now it's 3.5 years post-op, he's doing fine, no problem. The third methodology is arthrodesis, or rather the last methodology is arthrodesis, which is called a gold standard. In a young patient with global arthritis, patients with gloss deformities, patients with infection, neuropathy, gross instability, bone loss, fusion would be gold standard. That's a malunited ankle fracture which was treated with transfibular arthrodesis. And look at here, I've used this fibula as a live plate and fix it up. Sometimes I also fix it up proximally with tibia and distally with the talus. If there is an associated fracture, you might have to extend the fusion complex further proximally and do it like this. So this non-union of pilon with ankle arthritis, extension of fusion complex was also done for pilon fracture. Another situation, patient treated like this, went into infection, and this is how he ended up. Varus, and then this kind of fusion was done. Neuropathic ankle fracture, fusion is the gold standard. This case was showed yesterday, so I'll run very fast. So friends, where all this boxed down to? So let me take you to an algorithmic approach to ankle malunion. Age and activity. If the patient is young patient, active, always think of revising it. And if at all there is a set arthritis, think of total ankle replacement over fusion. But for an old and sedentary patient, you should always think for fusion or sometimes orthotics. If there is arthritis with deformity and it's a minimal arthritis or deformity, you could think for osteotomy. If the deformity is less or smaller deformity, you could think of doing distal osteotomy. If it is a large deformity, you could go in for the proximal deformity. If you have a minimal deformity in a young patient with arthritis, you could think of total ankle replacement. But global arthritis, severe deformity, fusion is gold standard. Infection, diabetes, fusion would always is always preferred over revising the fixation. Coronal plane malunion with or malunion in valgus would be tolerated by ankle, and you may leave it alone. But sagittal plane malunion or malunion in Varas, you need to revise or you need to go in for the fusion. That's all. Thank you so very much.